crazy. Please welcome her.
Rule number one on how to get away with anything: wrap it in a bow and name it politics. Greetings, everyone. I am Nishma Pokhrel from grade 11, and today I am going to be. First of all, I would like to speak for the motion. As we know, as I like to call it, everything in this world is relative. Every decision has its pros and its cons. So first of all, let me list some of the pros of the decision made by Prime Minister Oli on 20th December 2020. First of all, Prime Minister Oli's decision saved our country from being ruled by a party with internal politics, which would have meant 2 more years of political leaders in their high horses, altercating with each other while the depressed people just sit back and watch this dirty mess. The 2 years which would have gone in waste if handled by the current government now can result in something if the power goes in the right hands and of the right people. While justifying the decision made by Prime Minister Oli, he mentioned the process or the ritual of horse trading in the parliament. If this is true, and if there was horse trading going on in the parliament, then, and if the parliament members are supporting a leader and supporting only one side and completely turning a blind eye to what is right, what is wrong, what the country needs and what the people of the country need, then there is no use of such parliament. That parliament is worthless. The current prime minister of our country, who was a leader of the political party who garnered highest vote, majority vote in the 2017 elections, and most importantly, our prime minister was cornered. So this was a direct disrespect to the support, the vote of the people of the nation. It was a direct mockery and a disrespect to the democracy of the country. Now, fresh elections can help Nepal see the bright light at the end of the tunnel. If political consciousness among people will ignite and people will start looking at the agendas and the enthusiasm and the commitment of the political parties to carry out those agendas, then our country can somewhat progress and somewhat this whole mess can be fruitful. And Nepal is not the first country to dissolve parliament before its tenure. Many politically established countries like Canada, India, among many others in the world, have done it before. So there is no compulsion that this decision of Prime Minister Oli will only result in the political crisis. If we try to see it from the Prime Minister's perspective and be a little optimistic, then we can see that this is a right chance and a golden opportunity to elect an enthusiastic, a stable, and a responsible government. Now, these were the pros of the decision made by our Prime Minister on 20th December. Let me list some of the cons as well. The action of Prime Minister Oli to dissolve the parliament has pushed the country into the state of a constitutional crisis and is a direct mockery of democracy and is disgustingly selfish. Article 76 of our constitution does not allow dissolution of parliament in the current situation that our Prime Minister did. But the executive, which was supposed to implement the constitution, if they themselves go blatantly against it, then that is hypocrisy in its truest form. K.P. Sharma Oli and Vidya Devi Bhandari, who basically decided for the whole country, they went against the constitutional spirit. Also, of fresh elections will be a costly exercise. It will cost about 30 billion, which could have at this moment used for the vaccines for COVID-19. But no, our government does not seem to have the fundings for COVID-19 vaccination and is asking for donations. But for an unnecessary midterm election, there seems to be no financial problems. The priorities are completely out of place. So if the Supreme Court will try and see the events that took place leading up to this decision, then the constitutional bench is wise enough to take the right decision. And the only right decision in this case is declaring the Prime Minister and the President. This is as unconstitutional and explosion of authority. Thank you.
Global College of Management, Mid Baneshwar. Management studies from plus two to master's level. Phone 4490021 www.globalcollege.edu.np.